Hello, this is Robert Benoit, and I'm here with Meshach in India, and we are going to do a little recording this morning and discuss the last video we put out. And just so you know, we did a video calling Servus Christi. And let me stop for a minute. If I haven't told you already, this is Babylon Rescue. Our ministry is we're calling people out of Babylon. And now some people think that we've perhaps lost it, but I don't understand that way of thinking. No, we haven't lost it. We know exactly what we're talking about. We're calling people out of Babylon. That's why our ministry is Babylon Rescue. And we had a question for a man by the name of Joshua Chavez about half a month ago. And Joshua, unfortunately, has refused to answer us in any responsible way. So we're gonna move on. You know, we can't really sit and wait forever for him to answer. But he also goes as Servus Christi is what he goes as. And again, you know, I posed the question last video, the video that we did calling Joshua Chavez out of Babylon. We asked the question, whether or not we would he would be open to have fellowship with us, and the real question is whether we are a part of him or he is a part of them. And that's the real question, and we're asking him. And again, small response that I got from Joshua is that it was more along the line of I'm busy and you're selfish for demanding my time. That's basically what he said. And I said, no, I'm not selfish. I'm just persistent. And I would appreciate if Joshua would spend the time to answer us. And so we have to come to the point in time that no answer is an answer of sort. And this is something that is one of my pet peeves, if you will, is that people that get a little bit of a recognition out there. Now, again, I'm going to keep the door open for Joshua Chavez, Servus Christi, if he would like to answer us the video. We gave you a very direct and very reasonable question, and we would like an answer. And if you can't answer it, then we know why, okay? We understand what's going on here. Even if you're not talking, we know what's going on. And this is what we're going to believe. If you don't want to answer us, we're going to believe that you don't think that we're worth your time. And that's very, that's just not what the scripture says. You know, let me go point to a few scriptures here. This is what really irks me about some people, is that they have an evil imagination, and they come up with imaginations over strangers, and they're not really obedient to the scripture. And I mean, I can just read in Hebrews 13, starting at verse 1, it says, let brotherly love continue. And it says in Hebrews 13:2, it says, be not forgetful to entertain strangers, for thereby some have entertained angels. I mean, when you're dealing with a stranger, you don't really know who you're talking to. And to assume that you're Mr. Big Pants and you don't really need to answer small people back, that's a mistake. That's a real big mistake. And I'll get into talking about this a little bit more, but let me go to another scripture, 1 Peter 3:15, but sanctify the Lord in your hearts and be ready to always to give an answer to every man that asketh you a reason of the hope that is in you with meekness and fear, having a good conscience, that whereas they speak evil of you as evildoers, they may be ashamed that falsely accuse your good conversation in Christ. Another one, 2 Corinthians 5:11, knowing therefore the terror of the Lord, we persuade men, but are made manifest unto God, and I trust also are made manifest in your consciences. We commend not ourselves again unto you, but give you occasion to glory on our behalf, that you may have somewhat to answer them which glory in appearance and not in heart. You know, again, this is what happens to people. They get a pretty good following on the internet, and they think somehow or another that that they're above other people, and they don't really need to answer people. They don't need to respond with respect and answer seriously. You know, again, you know, we're calling Mr. Christi, Servus Christi, Joshua Chavez, out of Babylon. You know, right now he's in a system where people are you know, putting hit pieces out on each other, and here's their cameras out of focus. But anyway, people putting hit pieces on each other. I mean, you should see the hit piece that that Moriel Ministries put out on Joshua. You know, is that the kind of thing you want to live? You want to live that way, Joshua? You know, I'm talking to you, and I believe me, we get together. I am not looking to get fame and fortune or to get on your coattails. I'm not interested in that. You know, the man that you rebuked recently, a man by the name of Jacob Presh, I rebuked that man many years ago, before you were even around. I rebuked that man. I mean, you might even be able to find it on the internet. It's called Suffer the Little Children. I've always known Jacob Presh. He's a self-promoter. I've known that from day one. Apparently, Joshua, you didn't know that, okay? So I guess my sniffer is a little better than yours. My discernment is a little better than yours. No, I'm not coming to you because I want to ride on your coattails. You know, let's get your evil imaginations out. Just answer me, okay? It's not a big deal. You can answer honestly. It's no big deal. I'm not asking you to give me your firstborn child or anything. You know, really. You know, but what we are facing is a crisis in Christianity today, and the answer is not going around and using authority in a way that it's not to be. Do I think that Jacob Presh, when he says about you that you're not qualified to minister, do I think that that's authoritative? His board, anyway, that put out that hit piece on you? Yeah. You know, look at the way you guys are responding back and forth to each other. It's, you know, I don't want to be a part of that. I don't understand why you want to be a part of that. You know, that's Babylon. That's the way you guys operate in Babylon. And this is why I'm asking the question about authority. Do you know where authority comes from? And that's the question I asked last week. And, you know, I'm not intimidated by these people and their hit pieces. I don't survive based upon the way you or anyone else thinks about me. And really, I'll care when it comes to the point of what God thinks. I care what God thinks. I fear the Lord. Absolutely. But I don't fear men. I'm not interested in having some great following, and I'm going to get a hold of Joshua Chavez, and I'm going to make all everybody that listens to him will maybe start listening to me. Really? No. I'm just asking, you know, are you a part of them? Or are you a part of us? You know, scripture says if you have fellowship with one another, then your fellowship is truly with Christ, and the blood of Jesus Christ cleanses you from all sin. Did I mention to you, Joshua, that you're not my elder? Just so you know, I'm older than you, you know, and you're going to find real quick that, you know, it's just funny. You know, I offer people things, and it's interesting. People that, you know, you offer them things that are valuable. You know, by the way, Joshua, truth is valuable. It's hard to come by. You know, the Lord hides his truth from those who are wise in this world. And the Lord gives people over to their idols, Christians over to their idols. You know, you've experienced that with these people, the way that they operate. The Lord gives them over to their idols. And that's why they believe. They read the same scriptures you and I read, and they come up with something completely different because the Lord's given them over to their false doctrine. They've just given them over to their idols. You know, so truth is valuable. The truth will set us free. I always ask people, many times I ask them, I say, when Isaiah said, Lord, here am I, send me, what was Isaiah talking about? And I ask people that question sometimes, and hardly ever can people give me the correct answer. The correct answer is that the Lord said to Isaiah, go to these people and cause them to have eyes that don't see and ears that don't hear, lest I heal them, unless they see the truth and they be healed. Truth is valuable, okay? And I'm not coming here offering you something that's not valuable, Joshua, okay? Just because I'm offering it to you. Sometimes I think people think that, well, it can't be valuable if you're offering it. And of course, if I tried to sell it, you know, then people would accuse me of something else. You know how that works, right? Okay, but what I have is valuable, all right? And I'm an honest person. I'm a godly man, all right? You have nothing to fear from me. However, you know, if I have to go before the throne of God in regards to you, you do have something to fear. I can assure you of that, okay? I'm not impressed with these big people, Jacob Presch, self-promoter. I'm not impressed with them. People are blind. They want to follow the blind, lead the blind, and they both follow the ditch. You know, what am I going to do about that? Okay. The fact of the matter is I have truth. I'm walking in truth. The Lord's opened my eyes to a lot of things. And, you know, that's going to be very valuable. That's going to be very valuable for anyone who fellowships with me and anyone who hears me. You know, let me read you a scripture here, you know, that some people, you know, they just don't understand. Maybe they don't understand where I'm coming from, okay? Because I am kind of a deep person, and sometimes I'm hard to understand. I realize that, okay? But I'm looking. I got a vision. I'm looking for something, okay? This is why we're getting in touch with you, Joshua. We're looking for something. We're asking you the question, are you the man, or do we look for another? You know, now don't take that too, you know, I'm not saying you're Jesus or anything. I'm saying, you know, today we're looking for men. We want to know who the men are, who the people that are going to stand for the truth are. And I don't know why my camera's going in and out on me, but whatever, let's just keep on going here. But I'm going to read you a scripture. Here's the vision that I have. And when I calling people, God's people out of Babylon, I know exactly what I'm talking about, okay? The Lord has given his people over to captivity, okay? And captivity means they don't have truth, so they're captive. They've got their eyes blind, like in Isaiah chapter 6. They have eyes that don't see and ears that don't hear, all right? God has given, Babylon means confusion. We know, according to Daniel chapter 2, that statue of Daniel, that statue in Daniel chapter 2 would stand from that time until Jesus returns. And at the return of Jesus Christ, that statue is going to be destroyed by that stone, which was hewn without hand, which is Jesus Christ. Clearly, Jesus Christ. So I've got a vision, and I'm calling people out of what the Catholic Church, I mean, all roads lead back to Rome. Where you get your idea of authority from goes right back to the Catholic Church, does it not? I mean, that's a question I'm asking. Can you answer it? You know, you think that it seems like to me that your idea of authority is exactly the same. Now, I could be wrong. I want to know if I'm wrong. Again, you the man, do we look for another? Okay, that's the issue here. All right. So I wish that you would be a little bit more respectful and answer us in a respectful way. I'd appreciate that. But that's okay. You know, if you don't, it's on you. Okay. You know, I'm trying to do a good thing here, right? And I'm not looking for your popularity. I don't care about your popularity. You happen to be in my view, and so we're talking. That's all. So anyway, let me read the promise that I see the Lord, that I'm looking for. Okay. There's a few promises in scripture that I'm looking, to see fulfilled. And to me, that's integral, in our ministry of calling people out of the religious system, calling them out of Babylon. And I'm not calling them out of Babylon just so I could promote myself or, you know, start another denomination. No. No, I'm calling people out of Babylon according to the word of God. And let me just read this right here. Okay, I gotta open this up. Okay. Here's the promise. It's found in Isaiah 66:6. And here it says this. It says, a voice of noise from the city, a voice from the temple, a voice of the Lord that rendereth recompense to his enemies. Before she travailed, she brought forth. Before her pain came, she was delivered of a man-child. OK, Okay, that is the promise right there, Mr. Christie. Okay, who hath heard such a thing? Who hath seen such things? Shall the earth be made to bring forth in one day, or shall a nation be born at once? As soon as Zion travailed, she brought forth her children. Okay, now while you are going back and forth, you're judging the people who know who can be behind the pulpit, an unscriptural thing. Who's qualified for this and who's qualified for that? And this man is a liar and everything that you do. I'm not saying that what you're doing, you're not wrong on everything. I'm not saying that, okay? But what I am saying is that, you know, look at look at the hits they put on you. Look at the hits that you put on them. I mean, is it working? Is that working? Because what that is not doing is bringing about this prophecy right here. Okay, the prophecy is also repeated, by the way, in Revelations. It's called 144,000, Joshua. Okay, and the Lord, you know, this whole idea that the nation of Israel in the Middle East is the fulfillment of this prophecy is about the biggest lie I have ever heard. It's such a complete phony, fake lie. No, the prophecy here is talking about the people of the Lord. And the child that Zion is going to have is Jesus Christ. That's the child that is going to be born of this Zion. Okay, so what I'm talking about is the glory of the Lord here. That's what I'm talking about. Okay, now you, again, I ask you the question, are you trying to heal Babylon? That's really the question. You trying to heal Babylon? Okay, what I'm trying to do and what I'm calling people to is this. That's what I'm looking for. That's what I'm hoping for. Okay, so again, we are not going to sit around and beg people to listen to us. And you know, occasionally we do send emails to people and we ask them, you know, you the man? You know, are we just trying to heal Babylon? All right. This is what is on my heart. I'm not here to heal Babylon. I'm here to go out of Babylon. And when I come out of Babylon, I'm interested in having fellowship with my brothers, as the scripture says, as the day approaches, you know, forsake not the assembling of yourselves together as the day approaches. Okay, but I don't go into a building and sit down as they claim and submit myself to the pastor. No, that's not the way it works. No, I'm a lively stone, and when I go someplace, I continue to be the lively stone that I am, and I'm not going to have some guy you know, half my age. I have children older than him. He's not going to be my elder. I can assure you of that. Okay, I don't need to have an elder. I am an elder, by the way, okay? And my authority comes from the Lord, and it's called going before his throne. That's where authority comes from, all right? It's not men approving of men. That's not where authority comes from. And I don't know, somehow or other, I don't think that you believe that, Josh. And so, and I could be wrong, okay? And I'm open to that, okay? But certainly don't know anything when somebody won't talk to you. Now, can you? Now, if you want to play this game, fine. You go ahead, play this game. But we're moving on if we need to, okay? But you certainly haven't given us a very good impression by claiming when I contacted you and I just wanted you to tell us that you received our email that you called us selfish. We're not selfish. We're godly. That's what we are, Josh. And we think that you should have a little bit more respect when you're talking to people that you don't really know. That we're strangers to you, right? And but believe me, you know, Josh, you know, way before you were ever doing any of this, I was rebuking Jacob Presh. Okay, I can assure you of that. And you know what? You know what Jacob Presh said to me when I rebuked him? He said, "Who do you think you are?" Now, isn't that kind of the thing that you said to me when I asked you to respond to me? It was kind of like that, wasn't it? It was like, "Do you know who you're talking to here? I'm busy." That's the impression you gave us, Josh, okay? And we kind of know, we kind of get that sense, all right? So I think you should straighten that up, okay? Don't treat strangers lightly, Josh. It doesn't show wisdom on your part. Okay, you really don't know me. I trust me, you don't. You know, there's been people that has tried to do these hits on me. I remember a guy once, tried to claim that I was a cult. I was a member of a cult. I was a cult leader because I had Bible study with my family at home. And it just these people are so ridiculous. They're liars. They're cheats. You know, they deserve no respect at all. I mean, is that where you're going to compete with them, right, Josh? That's what you're going to do, right? Fine. I'm not going to compete with them because I'm not a liar. I've got the truth. Okay. So again, here we are. We're waiting. And we're looking for something, not healing Babylon. That's not what we're looking for. We're looking for the glory of the Lord. That's what we're looking for. And so these promises of the Lord sanctifying his people before the face of the whole earth, that's what we're looking for. Okay? We're not looking to start another denomination and have a bunch of people following us. No, we the people that are that are around us, they're blessed, okay? They're blessed. It's called truth. It's valuable, okay? Because I guarantee you, Jacob Prash doesn't have it. He doesn't. He's never had it, okay? That's how why he likes to go around pretending to be a Jew, you know? I mean, it's these people just, they just do not get my respect. They don't deserve my respect. Okay, when you know how to speak Hebrew, that doesn't earn you my respect. Okay, big deal. But you have the Holy Spirit. Is the Holy Spirit leading you into truth? Is the Lord pleased with you? These are the things that are is matters to me. What is the Lord? Where's the Lord at? You know, is the Lord for you? If God's for you, no one can be against you. And I saw the hit piece that they put out on you, Josh, over at the board of Moriel Ministries, I guess it was. You know, I'm telling you, Josh, I feel sorry for you. I really do, dealing with these people, and I certainly hope you know what you're doing, because it looks like to me that it's a bunch of people, using their swords to try to kill one another. You know, brother against brother, taking your swords out and judging each other according to the letter. I hope that's working for you, because I don't see how it is, but okay. All right. But anyway, we're going to move on. And if you ever decide you want to talk about it, I'm a plain, simple man. You can get a hold of me. I talk to people. I'm not too important to answer people when they email me. There's some emails that are really important. I think ours was pretty darn important. So unfortunate that you decided not to respond to us in a timely manner anyway. Okay. So like I said, we'll move on. We're going to talk about in upcoming videos, we're going to be talking about the stumbling stone. You know, the scripture says, it says, take the stumbling stone out from before the face of my people. And we're going to talk about that. We're going to be talking about this whole false teaching called Calvinism, and this false teaching called Arminian, or if I can even say it right, the isms, if you will. Okay, the there's two opposing points of view that seems to be that everybody is told they must believe one or the other, and I'm disputing that. I'm saying you don't have to believe one or the other. As a matter of fact, the Lord is calling us to take away those stumbling blocks from before the face of the people of the Lord. And so we're going to talk about this. These are stumbling blocks. I mean, when you go out in the scripture says that, that God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever, but you say, no, only the elect, Jesus only died for the elect, and Jesus only loves the elect, and he doesn't love anyone else. I'm sorry. That's it's a stumbling stone. That's what it is. And so we're going to talk about that in upcoming videos. But here I decided to come on today and just put to rest. And if we don't hear from Josh, fine, you know, that's fine. You know, if you want to bring up the conversation again, Josh, I'm more than willing to bring it up. But we're moving on if nothing else happens. Okay. So that's just one, again, try to reiterate what we're about here. We're calling the people of the Lord out of Babylon. We know what Babylon is. We understand. And we're calling God's people out of that. And we are also looking for the glory of the Lord. And we're looking for men to stand up against Babylon, against this religious system. We're looking for that. And we want to be a part of it. We understand exactly what these people are doing. And we want to be part of the men. You know, here's a man right here. You know, I'm a man. I stand up for truth. And we're looking for men that are willing to stand up for truth as well against this wicked religious system. And we don't care at all. We could care less who says, if they want to, somebody wants to say that Robert Bonneau is not qualified for ministry. Yeah, I have 7 children, have been married 38 years. I mean, come on, you know, 7 grandchildren and a great grandchild. And I don't know, you know, again, you know, I have a little bit of experience under my belt. But still, you know, what people say, whether they say that I'm qualified or not, is meaningless to me. It really is. But one thing I do know is I have truth, and there isn't anybody that could stand. You want to talk to me? Okay. You won't stand. Okay. The Lord's given me a sharp sword, and I know how to use it. Okay. With wisdom, I know how to use it. Okay. I have truth. And that's, if people think that that's a brag, I'm sorry, it's not. It's just true. You know, I got tired a long time ago going, you know, you go and you sit down in the back of a church somewhere and you're there for 6 months and hardly anybody even talks to you, you know, and now, you know, people treat you as if you are just some newbie. You don't even know anything. And you're not a lively stone. You're just a brick. You know, you sit in the back of the pew. I'm not going to sit in the back of the pew anymore. I'm not going to sit there and listen to some guy talk to me that, you know, has the wit that I have children older than, you know, they more wise than them. And they went to some little seminary and now they're going to give us this little talk, you know, and to share with us their vision. And I'm saying baloney. I'm sitting here. I'm a lively stone and I have something to say and I'm going to be who God has called me to be. So I'm not looking to go and be anybody's boy out there, okay? Because I'm going to be a man. That's what God has called me to be. And if people don't like that, what can I say? You know, please convince me. Where's my sin? Show me. I'd like to know, where's my sin? And if you come to me and say, oh, you're rebellious. Oh, really? You're a joke. No, I'm not rebellious. I obey the Lord. And he's my Savior. He's my God, okay? No, I don't obey you because what you're saying is not right. Okay. If you want to say what's right, then I'll do what's right. I submit myself to one another in the fear of God, just like the scripture says. Okay. So if you can't tell me where my sin is, then it's going to be real tough to rebuke me. You see how that works? Real tough. And that's the same thing Jesus said to the religious leaders of his day. He said, you know, here I am telling you the truth and you want to kill me. He said, can you tell me my sin? You know, they said, who are you to do such things, Jesus? He said, you don't have any authority, Jesus. Where do you get your authority from, Jesus? That's what religious people do. They think that somehow or another, if you're not a part of their system, that you don't have any authority. And unfortunately, they were wrong with respect to Jesus. We all know the story about that. Okay, but nothing's changed. Babylon's still standing. And, you know, the devil says, I will sit in the congregation on the sides of the north. I will be like the Most High God. Yes, the devil's sitting up on those platforms in those churches every single week around the fancy, the high places of the church and making everyone else sit down and listen to them talk because they're so wise. And everybody else, of course, just has to sit like little mice in the pew and listen and, you know, it's like we got a bunch of children out there in the pew listening to daddy on the platform. It's just sick. It really is. No, I'm a lively stone. I don't do that kind of stuff. And no one's going to tell me that anything different. The Lord's caused me to be quite secure in the truth that He's given me. And yes, I do walk in humility, but I'm not afraid to tell people the truth. And I'm not going to sit around six months for you to figure out that you're not my elder. Okay, you're not older than me in the things of the Lord, and I know exactly what I'm talking about. I'm not going to wait 6 months, a year, 2 years, and listen to your dribble behind the pulpit, you know, because that's what it is, dribble. You know, I don't have time for that. You know, but I am a godly man, and I do love my brothers, and I do want to have fellowship, and I do want to build up people in the most holy faith, and I do care about people, because the truth sets people free, and they need the truth. You know, it's ridiculous the things that people are splitting over and fighting over in Babylon, in the harlot church system. That's what I call it, because that's what it is. But the Lord is not going to be healing Babylon. He's going to be destroying Babylon. So anyway, like I said, in the future, we're going to be coming back and speaking about these stumbling stones. And we'll get into maybe some more scriptures, stuff like that. So anyway, God bless you all on this Sunday, and we'll get this video out as soon as we can, probably next week sometime, and I hope we can get a few people of you to pray with us and pray for our ministry and desires to be a part of it too. You know, if you're a lively stone, if you're a man, we're looking for you. You know, we want to fellowship with you. And if you're listening to people that are, you know, that are speaking evil about us, that don't even know us, you should be ashamed of yourself. You really should. You know, you need to be right. If you judge somebody wrongly, then God is going to judge you by the same measure you judge others. So let's stop being, let's stop the Facebook anonymous, you know, judgments. Judging strangers, judging things you don't even know about. Let's stop that, okay? And I'm giving people an opportunity not to know the Robert in their imaginations, but I'm giving people the opportunity to know who I really am. And that's makes me quite vulnerable, and that's okay. That's okay, because I'm a man of God. That's what I am, and I don't have to be ashamed about saying that. And I'm not going to wait around for you to tell me that, that's for sure, because I know it's not going to happen, at least, you know. But we are calling people out of Babylon. So God bless you. Have a good day. Talk to you later. Bye now.